enrolled in the South Coast Regional Occupational Programs at Course for Adventure earlier this month when they launched model boats with GPS tracking on them. Their aim was Hawaii, but as they soon found out, it's not the destination, but the journey that is the learning experience. We welcome ROP Instructor Malcolm Wilson along with model boat team leader Scotty Panici. Glad to have you both with us.
Thank you.
All right, talk a little bit, Malcolm, about what you would hope to achieve if things went perfectly in putting these model boats in the water and just sending them off to Hawaii.
Well, I think the fun part was just the act of designing and building them, getting the students involved, you know, in all aspects of that.
Mm-hmm.
That was kind of exciting, launching them off and not knowing exactly where they'd end up. Hawaii might have been a little optimistic. It's kind of left up to the winds, and
right.
We didn't get the westerlies. We got some kind of northwesterlies, so they headed a little north. But at this point, one of them's traveled almost 1,300 miles, which I think is quite an accomplishment.
Yeah. They're all rigged with GPS, is that correct?
We've got GPS transmitters that report once every 2 hours, so we can kind of calculate their speed.
Okay.
And tell where they are at any given time.
We're looking at some video right now of a launch. Scotty, did you help build one of these models?
Yes, I did, actually. I helped build the Humuhumu Nuku Nuku Apua'a.
Oh, that's a simple name.
Kind of. And it took about, 5-6 months to build.
Uh-huh.
And we launched it from Sankumani Island in May or June.
Okay.
And that one actually traveled south. About 400, 500, 600 miles.
Okay.
And right now the battery died, so we don't really know where it is.
You don't know where it ended up?
No.
Huh. Well, Malcolm, how did this project come about in the first place?
Well, when I first started teaching this course, it was nice. I got the liberty to kind of come up with my own curriculum.
Mm-hmm.
And we did architectural models and mold making and casting, and I really loved sailing and building models myself, so I thought, why don't we build a sailboat? And we built one several years ago and decided just to launch it out to sea with a note in it. And it was a lot of fun, so we did it the next year and the next year after that. And it's been getting a little bit better and bigger every year.
Uh-huh. You're building bigger boats every year.
Going farther every year.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Have you ever heard from anyone who's found the boat and found the note?
Several times.
Really?
Heard from the U.S. Coast Guard.
Oh. Oh.
They were very nice. Uh-huh. We had the Navy searching for one of our boats that hit San Clemente Island.
Uh-huh.
Had a fisherman pick one up off of San Diego. They're spotted by different people and then re-released.
Oh.
And, still waiting to hear from somebody in some far-out place.
Mexico.
Could be Oregon, could be Mexico.
Never know.
Well, Scott, how did you get involved and talk about the boats, how they were built, and the size of these boats?
Well, it's about my boat was a 6-foot boat, and I think the biggest one was 7.5-8 feet.
Mm-hmm.
But I kind of got involved. I saw the class, and I was like, okay, that kind of looks interesting. I heard we build boats. I heard they're not that big. So, you know, I think the first boat was
like 3 feet long.
Yeah. And so what we did was we kind of jumped it up a little bit, and we made our boat about 2, 3, 4 feet bigger. We made a wooden deck, and we did all the design work, all the painting, all the craftsmanship. We shaved the foam and made it. Well, you had a choice between a trimaran or a monohull.
Mm-hmm.
And what we did was we pretty much just made this beautiful looking boat. It was a We painted the Hawaii state fish on it, and it turned out really good. But
it was beautiful.
We hand painted the sails, hand did the wooden deck, and
wow. Were you a little sad to let it go? Because the chances of you getting it back are pretty slim.
Yeah.
So. Malcolm, what's your? It's such a cool story, and so great. You see, I mean, such enthusiasm building the boats and then setting them off. But what's your hope that the kids will learn? Ultimately, you're trying to teach them something.
Well, I mean, they're learning. A little engineering,
mm-hmm.
a little design work. They're learning about the ocean and navigation.
Still a bunch of physics.
There's physics involved, math. I mean, it all comes into play when you're, you know, whether you're calculating speed of the boats,
mm-hmm.
you know, and so on.
Mm-hmm.
The people, the other kids, the mm-hmm. students who were involved in this thing,
yeah.
what was the interaction like for you guys?
At first it was kind of slow, you know, because we got some kids in there that were actually in the class for, you know, specifically building a boat. And then we got some other kids that, you know, kind of weren't into it at first. But it turned out that, you know, by the end of the course, a lot of kids were actually starting to get really involved in it. A lot of kids started, you know, they really wanted to put some work into it because they realized how big of a deal it kind of turned out to be. And
it's a lot of pride.
Yeah. I mean, it's a lot of our own work into it. I mean, it's, you put into it, and then you kind of just let it go, and right. If it makes it to Hawaii, that's a huge accomplishment for us.
But right. It makes it anywhere,
Yeah. Anywhere besides California, at least.
You turn it back.
Yeah,
now that you've completed it, though, Scotty, what do you feel like you could do? Did you learn?
I definitely learned some, like, craftsmanship, you know, attention to detail, because, I mean, you do one little thing wrong, I mean, you cut the sail an inch short, and that could ruin the whole trip of the boat. I mean, it could definitely, you shake the mast wrong.
Yeah.
It can go wrong, so.
Right.
I don't know. It was a really fun class. I mean, we definitely picked up some skills that I haven't learned.
If he ever gets shipwrecked on a desert island, he'll make his way on.
I can make my own boat. I mean,
that's cool.
That's the good news about it, but it was just a really cool class, really cool experience. I'd definitely recommend it. I mean, if other schools started doing it, it'd be cool to have some, like, contests or competitions so your boat can get farther.
That would be great.
Yeah.
Now, the GPS is still working on the one boat.
On the one, it
just
is.
The one.
Sporadically,
Okay, and you're just hanging on to finding out sort of where it's at?
Yeah, right now it's up in some doldrums up, like about 800 miles off of Santa Rosa.
Oh, okay.
And the winds are kind of spinning around, so it's done about 200 miles in a kind of circular course,
So.
Not those westerly.
Yeah.
The weather seldom cooperates.
Yeah, that's another lesson right there.
That's right. Well, thank you both for joining us. We really appreciate you coming in. Great story.
Thank you for having us.
All right.
Yeah.